Hello, students. Today we're going to be going over the endocrine structures in the pig. Now, appreciate we're not cutting open the skull, so we will not be looking at the hypothalamus or the pituitary or the pineal gland, okay? But we will be looking at the structures within the thoracic, cervical, thoracic, and abdominal pelvic cavities. So first, let's start anteriorly, and the first one that we're going to see here is going to be the thyroid. So remember, the thyroid is this butterfly shaped structure, and if you were to you can actually see that it's two lobes here, so one on this side, one on this side, and this sits just anterior to the trachea. And so look for the tracheal rings that will help you orient. Look for the larynx, and it's just below that. So if you see a dark kind of rounded structure just below the larynx and anterior to the trachea, it's probably going to be your thyroid. Okay. Additionally, we have, and if you can remember, the thyroid for hormones, we have our T3 and T4, which regulate metabolism. And then, of course, we also secrete calcitonin. We cannot see here the parathyroid glands that are embedded within the thyroid. So I don't have a label for that because we can't actually see those specifically. If we move inferiorly, we're going to come down to some tissue that typically sits over the heart. And of course, it's very big here. So we've got our heart and we have the thymus. And remember, the thymus is important for T cell maturation. So remember, our T cells are made in the bone marrow and they migrate to the thymus and they go through the maturation process. And we have thymosin, thymopoietin. These are the hormones that are actually released to help in that maturation process. Additionally, while the heart is a cardiovascular organ, it does have some endocrine function. And remember, the heart also secretes ANP, atrial natriuretic peptide, and that is going to be for water balance and blood pressure regulation. So this is going to help lower our blood pressure when blood pressure is too high. So very, very important as far as our endocrine organs go. As we move inferiorly, just to get your orientation, my diaphragm is this structure here. Here's my liver. So I'm going to lift up the liver, and I'm actually going to be able to see the stomach. If I lift the stomach superiorly here, posterior and inferior to the stomach, we have the pancreas. So it's this tan globular looking tissue here, right here. And remember, that connects to our duodenum so we can release digestive enzymes. But endocrine wise, this is going to be important for blood glucose regulation. Remember, the pancreas produces glucagon and insulin. Insulin is going to lower blood sugar, and glucagon is going to raise that blood sugar up. So keep it at an appropriate level. As we move inferiorly, you're going to want to go ahead and lift your large intestine over here, move the cecum over here, and you're going to see a tan rounded structure here. This right here, beyond this peritoneal membrane, remember, the kidneys are retroperitoneal, so they're outside of the peritoneum. This is our kidney. And from the kidney, we actually have a tube that extends down towards the bladder. That will be the ureter. But here is the left kidney. So I'm going to show you that. I'll do a little peek over here to the right. We're not going to spend a lot of time on that. We'll do that in the urinary system. But here's the right kidney. So right kidney, left kidney. And then additionally, this is our male fetal pig. So if we move inferiorly, we also have an endocrine structure, the testicle. So here we have our testicle. The testicle is going to produce testosterone, which is going to be for male secondary sex characteristics, the development of male reproductive structures. And then, of course, testosterone also plays a role during the maturation process in increasing muscle mass and bone growth. For the kidney, just to reiterate, endocrine-wise, we release erythropoietin, and this is going to have a major effect on the bone marrow to produce blood cells. So in summary, we have the thyroid producing thyroid hormone and calcitonin. We cannot see the parathyroid, which produces parathyroid hormone. This is for calcium regulation, of course, and metabolism. We have the thymus for and it produces thymopoietin or thymosin, and this will be for T cell maturation. We have the heart, which produces ANP, atrial natriuretic peptide, for blood pressure regulation. We have the pancreas, which produces insulin and glucagon, and that is going to be for blood glucose regulation. We have the kidneys, which produce erythropoietin, EPO, and that is going to be for red blood cell production. And then, of course, we have our testicles in the male pig. that will be producing testosterone. When we have the female pig, we'll show you the ovaries for that structure.